Productronica 2017, and Electro Business is going to take a look at weird and unusual things. Not your ordinary soldering, not your ordinary repair, not your ordinary components, but only things that are special in my view. My name is Jan Buiting. Look at the booth at Elector. Quick shot. We have our staff, our magazines, more highlights, unusual stuff again. Spiral, Micro, Tesla, Laser, Clock, Nixie, Clock. Who builds with Nixies here at the show? Nobody. And LCR meter. Patrick, let's go and have a look at what's happening at the show. Come on. We've just had an awful long walk from our own booth at Hall A1. This is Hall A4 with Belver Sin, a company specialized in soldering wire. Now, this is your normal solder wire as you may have it at home, big reels, all sorts of compositions. But I was looking for a very special compound to repair Tektronix oscilloscopes, and it contains silver. And I spent like the entire show here, Productronica, and no one except Belvertsin had silver bearing solder. 3% silver in it. Amazing stuff. And Paolo, who's hiding from the camera here for the moment, kindly gave me these samples to repair my old oscilloscopes. It is a very special compound. It contains 3% silver, 3.00 silver.
Yes,
and this is pretty rare stuff. Just saying that Belvertsin has a wide assortment of solder tin varieties, including my very precious solder tin with silver. Very happy with that. That's it. Up next. So if you think this is a normal workbench with all your like LCDs, your readouts, even your comfy seat and your mains outlets all switchable and insulated, all safe and tested for ESR. Wonderful structure, light. It's nicely colored in green and it looks really sleek. You're in for a surprise. So if you're working like here, like if you're an engineer and say the financial boss is right sitting right next to you, look at the nice seat. Isn't that unusual? Let's see what's in the box, Tanya. This is a big surprise. Hey, look at that. If that's a normal workbench, I dare you. We've got a few things inside, like the Elector tool thing, multi-tool. We've got an offer for a free ESP board and our Peltier powered lamp. And we can close the magic drawer. It works like a charm. Unusual, we have more for you. Follow us. Now, if you think that all soldering is automated and flow production and mass production with automatic soldering equipment, think again. Here are a couple of chaps doing hand soldering and hand rework. Chris here at his workstation is busy trying to win a prize. Chris, aren't you? You're doing your level best soldering a specific project, aren't you?
I am. This is the hand soldering world championship board that the competitors will be doing on Friday. Uh-huh. As a master instructor.
Are you practicing?
I'm doing this to give them an example of what it is.
What are the specific difficulties, Chris? For beginners, let's say.
Well, for beginners, you can see the, if you look at the board, you've got different sizes of the components down to the 0201 components. Mm-hmm. More difficult to hand solder. We've got some where the solder connections are directly underneath the body, so they're harder to reach. Some interesting challenges for the competitor.
Does the project have to work in the end?
It does. It does. It's a functioning project at the end. Mm-hmm. So when I'm done with this, you should be able to see what it looks like.
Yeah. On a scale of 1 to 10, Chris, how difficult is it? Tell me honest.
Oh, about a 7 or an 8.
Yeah. So you should be able to do it? I should be able to do it.
Well, I don't know about beginners.
Trust me, I am not a beginner.
Not a beginner? No.
With my contact lenses out, I am not a beginner,
then
I can tell you.
Fine.
Yeah. Okay, thank you, Chris.
Thank you.
Good luck. More unusual and unexpected stuff at Productronica. Now, you may think that shoes are just shoes and you start soldering and working the thing again. You don't, you want ESD safe shoes, but they are terribly boring and old-fashioned, gray, black, or whatever. Now look at what DPV sells. These are actually ESD safe shoes, which are fashionable, let's put it that way. Look at the difference, what happens in my specific case. This is one of their models, ESD safe shoe, which looks quite fashionable. So look at the difference between a normal shoe, which you might like to wear in the office, but not in the electronics office, in the workplace, and this ESD shoe, which is quite fashionable, I would say light colored, but still ESD approved and ESD safe. So the company DPV has a whole assortment of nice looking shoes. They have more in terms of safety. Look at a field service kit, as it used to contain screwdrivers and stuff, but this is a field service kit which is entirely ESD safe to work within an ESD safe environment in the field, so to speak. But there's more here at the booth. It's not because it's winter or November or what have you. Gloves, not against the cold, but against static electricity. ESD approved, and everyone really should have a pair if you want to work in a certified and safe manner. So there's all sorts of fashionable things here at the DPV booth. Unusual. Weird and unusual things at Productronica 2017. They were weird and new for me personally. You may know this already, what we're going to see at Kurz Erza, but it was totally new to me and I made a fatal mistake. Ab jetzt sprechen wir Deutsch mit Manfred Wolf, genau. Von Kurz Erza. Danke Manfred. Ja. Entschuldigung für das Deutsch, aber ich hoffe, das klappt. Gestern war ich hier und dann hatte ich einen kapitalen Fehler gemacht, Manfred. Okay. Ja. Ich hatte gedacht, bei dieses Gerät hier, ja. Wo kommt denn, ich muss aufpassen, dass da heiße Luft mal draus kommt, he, aus, ja. Zum Löten. Ja. Ja. Aber da passiert etwas ganz anderes.
Genau, wir erhitzen Leiterplatten über die Unterseitenheizung und über die Oberseitenheizung nicht mit heißer Luft, sondern mit mittelwelliger Infrarotstrahlung. Besonders kleine Bauteile, wenn der Luftstrom zu groß ist, kann natürlich kleine Bauteile wegblasen. Bei diesem System, in dem dass wir mit Infrarotstrahlung arbeiten, funktioniert das Ganze berührungslos. Das heißt, der Infrarotstrahl erhitzt direkt den zu lötenden oder zu entlötenden Baustein und ich kann diesen mit einer Pipette entfernen. Man geht im Prinzip einfach oben drauf und nimmt ihn dann entsprechend weg. Also ist etwas, kommt aus dem Handybereich heraus, bei Handy sehr dichte Bestückung oder Mobile Phone oder Smartphone oder ähnliches, sehr dichte Bestückung, kleinste Bauteile, da ist das eine sicherlich sehr geeignete Lösung. Ja.
Und dann habe ich an dieser Draht habe ich mich gewundert hier.
Ah, ja.
Der Draht, ich habe gesagt zu Ihren Kollegen, Sie haben was vergessen da ist was lose, das kann doch wohl nicht richtig sein.
Ja, das ist bei uns ein bisschen anders. Wenn ich mit einem normalen Heißluftgerät arbeite, dann arbeite ich typischerweise mit Temperaturen im Bereich über 400 Grad. Und wenn man weiß, dass SMD-Bauteile bereits ab 260 Grad kaputt gehen, dann weiß man, dass man da etwas kaputt machen kann. Das heißt, das System selber wird über eine Software letztendlich überwacht. Das heißt, dieses Thermoelement misst die Temperatur nahe dem Baustein, den ich aus- und einzulöten habe und kontrolliert die maximale Temperatur. Das heißt, ich kann nichts überhitzen, sprich die Leiterplatte verbrennt dabei nicht.
Ja, und Manfred, das Ganze wird auch überwacht von einem PC, natürlich.
Genau, von einem PC, von einer Software, da kann man das Ganze dokumentieren, wird ja heute viel verlangt. Das heißt, ich kann dort auch Lötprofile einstellen, das heißt, wie schnell wird der Baustein heiß gemacht, beziehungsweise wie soll das Abkühlverhalten aussehen. Das ist heute eigentlich Standard, das braucht man.
Ja. Und das gewünschte Kurve wird eingegeben oder man kann man laden die Software überprüft auch, ob das stimmt,
ja,
ob das
genau,
alles funktioniert.
Ganz genau. Das heißt, über dieses Thermoelement wird ja die Ist-Temperatur der Baugruppe letztendlich aufgezeichnet und mit dem Sollprofil verglichen. Das heißt, wir haben in der Software, wenn man die auf einen neuen PC installiert, vier verschiedene Programme. Das heißt für leichte, also es wird jeweils angegeben, wie schwierig die Lötaufgabe ist, mittelschwer, leicht oder ganz schwer. Danach das entsprechende Lötprofil, das heißt die Endtemperatur, das sieht man auf der rechten Seite, da sehe ich 240 Grad. Mhm. Also heißer als 240 Grad wollen wir letztendlich nicht machen. Aber man sieht bei jedem einzelnen Lötprofil, dass dieser Wert nicht überschritten wird. Aber der Weg bis zur maximalen Temperatur, der kann etwas beeinflusst werden.
Ja. Und das Gerät, nehme ich an, das kompensiert alles, was so passiert mit genauer
Ganz genau. Das heißt also, wenn ich eine Vorgabe habe, wenn ich sage, ich möchte mit einem Kelvin pro Sekunde bis auf 240 Grad aufheizen, dann muss man jetzt bei diesem Gerät nicht hergehen und muss für jede Leiterplattentype, entweder ob niedrigmassig oder hochmassig, ein anderes Lötprofil wählen, sondern über den Sensor wird erkannt, wie viel Wärmebedarf notwendig ist, um diese gewünschte Kurve zu erreichen.
Ja. Manfred, herzlichen Dank für diese gute Erklärung und danke dafür, dass Sie meine Fehler so mal ein bisschen korrigiert haben. Ich habe etwas Neues für mich. Danke. Kurz Erza, Infrared Soldering, Productronica 2017. I've done a lot of soldering myself as a developing engineer and a tester and a repairman and what have you. Seen low power soldering irons, high power stuff, thin wire, thick wire, what have you. Various compositions, but I've never had any assistance from the soldering iron proper. Now, what happened? Here's the soldering iron, which tells you by lighting a green light that you are okay with the solder joint. Is that basically correct, Robert? Or?
Yes, absolutely. We've developed a new system called connection validation.
What is the connection and what is validated?
Right. We apply the solder or the tip to the joint, and what we do is calculate the intermetallic thickness in real time and provide feedback to the operator telling you that the intermetallic compound formation is correct or incorrect and give them feedback.
Do you do the calculations on paper with a pencil?
No, it's in real time. The system provides lighting and it has a little LED on the handpiece letting the operator know that yes, it's good and no, it's bad.
Show me.
Sure. So I apply the tip to the joint. A little bit of solder here to get the thermal bridge started. And as you see, I get a little flash saying, hey, it's red, green light. It's started. And it's calculated, and I get a green light saying that intermetallic compound is formed.
Now, that was a pretty heavy load. What happens if you start soldering SMDs with very tiny pads?
Well, same. There's no real difference. The system uses an inductive power supply, and it's power on demand. So this one requires much more power because of the size of the load. Yep. And a small surface mount SMD require much less power, but it doesn't change the fact that the connection will still be calculated in real time.
Yep. So, is it helpful for beginners? Silly question, perhaps.
Absolutely. It's actually valuable for beginners to experts because now you normalize the training process and you make it consistent so that every single joint, whether you're a new solder operator or an experienced one, your solder joints are going to be consistently the same.
Yeah.
Right.
So you just train the people to watch for the green light and everything will be okay.
Absolutely.
What sort of parameters are in this controller?
Everything from, you know, we have a new, for Metcal at least, we have a new temperature display, password control, the ability to actually export data. So this information that you're collecting, this red and green light, we can actually export this to an additional software piece, and you can go back and analyze that and look and actually see what the power was, what the temperature was, and you can actually see the success or failure of that solder joint.
So you can kind of monitor a beginning operator and help him develop a better solder practice.
Absolutely. You can go in there and baseline, say, your whole board and know exactly what it should be. And then when that operator's doing the repeat task and they fail, you can say, well, this is what it should look like. Here's what the parameters are. So it really helps educate them and take you to the next level of solder production.
Brilliant. Thank you, Robert.
No problem.
A soldering iron with a green light telling you it's okay. We've been speaking with a lot of people and we've seen many, many products. We've only highlighted a few strange and weird things, as you may have seen on the film, which I've been able to spot. There's another bunch of regular things going on, many, many things. And it's been a great success for Elector and also for Messe Munich, which we are very grateful to. Hope to catch you at Electronica 2018.